Hello, SICW wrestling fans, and welcome to a very special episode of Wrestling Explosion. We want to take just a moment. We are fresh off of our biggest event of the year. It was the Wrestling at the Chase anniversary, the Bruiser Brody Memorial. Battle Royals, title matches. It was a fantastic night, and we have a lot of people to thank for it. First and foremost, the greatest fans in the world, the SICW fans that were there in the East Carondelet Community Center with us on this special night. Shout out to Stan Hansen, AWA announcer, Mick Karsh, the lovely Barbara Goodish. Pat Matisik was in the house. It was a special, special evening, and we couldn't have done it without you great fans. Mr. Patrick Brandemeyer, thanks for being here on Wrestling Explosion. What can we look forward to on today's episode?
Well, Drew, we're going to take a look at the Bruiser Brody Memorial Battle Royal. All of the top competitors in SICW competing for that coveted trophy. We're going to see that here. We're also going to see the old school warrior Chaz Wesson going one-on-one with Waco. That and a whole lot more here on Wrestling Explosion.
The old season is over. The new season is coming. The Gateway Grizzlies are building for a spectacular 2015 campaign. The talent will be strong, hard-hitting, solid defense, reliable pitching. Plus, as always, the Grizzlies will have a schedule of superb promotions. It will be fun for the entire family at the right price. The Grizzlies were named the Frontier League Organization of the Year. The home for all this baseball excitement is a remarkable GCS ballpark. Make plans now to enjoy baseball the way it should be in 2015. For more information and updates, go to gatewaygrizzlies.com.
Unique and affordable gifts and collectibles on the internet are available at the Black Bear Haversack Trading Post. Go to blackbearhaversack.com. Semi-precious stones, bone horn and soapstone items, abalone shells, genuine coyote and water buffalo teeth pendants, products for Civil War, medieval and Renaissance reenactments, and so much more. For a 10% discount, mention SICW number 7 when you place your order. It's blackbearhaversack.com for top quality at reduced prices.
SICW fans, join us in the East Carondelet Community Center on June the 20th for a fantastic night of action. We try to get deeper into the Red River Jack mystery as Red River Jack teams with Ron Powers to take on the Travis Cook organization. Plus, old school warrior Chaz Wesson challenges for the Classic Wrestling Championship against our champ, Flash Flanagan. For tickets, call 618-286-4848 or visit us on SICW.org. All right, fans, here we go. Kicking off this episode with the very special Bruiser Brody Memorial Battle Royal. And as you see here, this is the majority of the SICW roster. The bell has rung and the action is underway.
Absolutely. We got a lot of top people in there. We got a lot of big guns in there. And you see everyone trying to gang up on the larger competitors here. You got to think they're going to be the favorites. You see Baracus, a newcomer to SICW, right here next to the camera. You see Bubba Troll in the corner being teamed up on by Chaz Wesson and Keith Smith Jr. This one could go in pretty much in any direction. I mean, you never know what can happen in a battle royal.
Well, you're absolutely right. I mean, these guys have to have eyes not just in the back of their head, but in the back, in the front, on the sides, or else you just have no idea what's happening around you.
And
there's a good 14, 15 competitors in here, and they're not sharing a ton of space. So, you know, this is one of those matches where you might get punched in the face, and you didn't even mean to be punched in the face. You were just in the way.
Absolutely. I mean, there could be allegiances. Like I said, we saw Chaz and Keith Jr. teaming up a little earlier, but only one man can win this. At the end of the day, only one guy can walk away with that coveted trophy.
Absolutely right, and that makes you think. Wonder what the plan is for groups like the Travis Cook organization, who does have a few members in there. So do they have a plan of one person maybe to get this win? Is it kind of all everyone for himself? Is it truly every man on his own? We'll find out what happens.
Well, we got Attila Khan in there. We've got Chris Hargis in there. Those are the main representatives of the Travis Cook organization. If it comes down to those two, I wonder what will happen. And right there we see Jake Durden going after Axe and Ricky Cruz just looking on. In this style of a match, it's entirely possible that you could just kind of hang back in a corner somewhere and just try to stay out of the line of fire, let the other guys wear each other out.
I know that'd be my strategy.
I've seen a couple of battle royals end where a guy pretty much hit outside the ring, and I've heard of a few managers like Jimmy Hart who would win battle royals that way.
Everybody's got their own strategy for a battle royal, and, you know, we've seen in history, pretty much every strategy has won a battle royal at one time or another. So really, I guess there really isn't one correct way to get it done.
And Jake Durden and Baracus, these two big bulls colliding head to head. And Daniel Gunner just went over the top at the hands of Bubba Troll. That's our first elimination.
Look at Baracus and Jake Durden kind of in the throes of battle as those are the two closest to us. Whoops.
And low bridge, and Baracus just hit the floor. That's the thing about this style of a match. Being the big guy could be an advantage, but on the other hand, it makes you a target as well.
Absolutely. And in Baracus's case, he's the man that we would probably call the irresistible force in a lot of these competitions. And unfortunately for his case, his force carried him up and over the top rope.
And Ricky Cruz just sent Curtis Wilde to the floor. That's our third elimination of the night. And Ricky Cruz, former classic wrestling champion, he's got to be considered a favorite, as well as Ron Powers. Ron Powers, a former protege of Bruiser Brody. You got to think, whoa, and there went Ron Powers. Travis Cook pulled down the top rope.
I think Travis Cook heard you talking up Ron Powers.
That guy has ears and eyes everywhere.
That's unfortunate because this is Ron Powers was the first man officially entered into this battle royal, and you know that's got to be heartbreaking to go right over the top rope, and really nobody even threw him over the top rope.
And as a former protege of Bruiser Brody, you got to think this held some special meaning for him. Someone who knew Bruiser Brody, who traveled with him, that it would have meant a lot to him to take that trophy home.
Absolutely right.
And right now this is anybody's ball game. Jake Durden, another guy obviously influenced by Bruiser Brody. You see it in his look, his style. That's a guy who could very easily walk out of here with that trophy as well.
Yes. A lot of people would say Jake Durden is actually the favorite in this match.
He could very well be. And we see Axe and Attila Khan going after, I believe, is Keith Smith Jr.?
Absolutely right. No easy breaks for Keith Smith Jr. Just a minute ago, he was stuck in between Attila Khan and Bubba Troll. What a terrible place to be. Not that between Attila Khan and Axe is any better.
And right now they're doubling up on him, trying to get him out of there. In the middle of the ring, you see Jake Durden and Bubba Troll slugging it out. What's going to give in that case? And now, right now, Ricky Cruz holding Bubba Troll.
I tell you what, that'd be a heck of a one-on-one contest there, Jake Durden and Bubba Troll.
Absolutely. And got to wonder who would be the powerhouse in that one. Well, but they're both powerhouses, but which one would come out on top?
Look at Attila Khan just standing right on the throat of Keith Smith Jr.
I believe Keith Jr. went over the... and Jake Durden with that clothesline took Bubba Troll out, but the momentum carried him to the floor as well.
Man, that's a danger of being near 300 pounds and, you know, throwing all your weight running towards those ropes. It doesn't take much to go up and over.
Absolutely.
Especially
right.
For somebody like Jake Durden, half of him is already higher than that top rope.
That's a case where being tall can work against you. And Keith Smith Jr. just hit the floor courtesy of Chris Hargis. You got to think that Travis Cook organization was possibly targeting Keith Smith Jr. And Ricky Cruz now perhaps looking to go after Chris Hargis. The field's thinning out a little bit here. You see Gary Jackson and Brandon Espinoza on the far side of the ring. Those two no strangers to each other.
Absolutely. They've had a long-standing issue that's made its way into this ring now for the past several months, and I don't think they still haven't found a resolution to their issues.
And Espy went over the top.
Whoops!
He pulled Gary out with him, but they both hit the floor.
Well, that certainly isn't going to bring an end to their issues either. So.
Yep, they battled that out in Millstadt recently. And Chaz Wesson with the drop kick, and out goes Waco.
Beautiful Chaz Wesson, that patented old-school warrior drop kick, getting it done right there.
And we've thinned it out. We got Ricky Cruz, Chaz Wesson, Axe, Attila Khan, and Chris Hargis. Travis Cook perhaps looking to direct traffic. He's got his two guys and Axe on one side. We got Ricky Cruz and Chaz Wesson on the other.
Well, you got to figure Ricky Cruz and Axe are definitely at the disadvantage here.
Wait a minute.
Cowboy Bob saying he saw Travis Cook. He saw what he did. And the director of operations, Cowboy Bob Orton, just reinstating Ron Powers back into this Bruiser Brody Memorial. What a second chance.
Absolutely. I mean, Cowboy Bob Orton was not going to stand by and let something like that happen with the importance of this battle royal.
Absolutely right. And that is exactly the sort of reason that we brought Cowboy Bob in to be the director of operations.
And we just saw, I believe Chaz Wesson sent Axe out of there, but Axe pulled Chaz out.
Oh, Ricky Cruz
just eliminated Attila Khan. Khan's already been eliminated, but he pulled Ricky Cruz out.
He sort of popped back up from the floor like the horror movie monster that you thought was dead came back for one last grasp.
And we're now down to Ron Powers and Chris Hargis, low bridge, and Ron Powers picks up the win in this Brody Battle Royal.
Belleville Mechanical Incorporated is the place to go for commercial and industrial heating, ventilation, air conditioning, and refrigerating work. Their Union Sheet Metal Shop is the most modern, well-equipped in southwestern Illinois. Their work on the SIUE Engineering Building won Belleville Mechanical the Madigan Special Merit Award for New Construction. Call 233-0081 for information. Belleville Mechanical will fabricate ductwork and custom fittings to your specifications. The highest union quality, superb workmanship, state-of-the-art equipment. Contact Belleville Mechanical.
SICW is pleased to welcome as a new sponsor Warma Witter Chrysler & Associates, Inc., independent insurance agent specializing in public entity insurance. For all your insurance needs, contact Bradley J. Chrysler at 618-632-7555, extension 806. That's 618-632-7555. When it comes to customer service for your insurance coverage, let Warma Witter Chrysler & Associates assist you.
Hello, SICW wrestling fans. I am nervously here with the Travis Cook organization. Mr. Cook, first of all, I got to address something. Your organization looks slightly different than it did last time. We saw a bit of dissension, and you kind of sicked your, I don't want to call them thugs, but you sicked your guys on what a lot of people call the cornerstone of the Travis Cook organization, Ken Casa. What happened?
There was no dissension. This is addition by subtraction. You know a certain quarterback in this town named Sam Bradford? He used to be really good in college. He got to the pros, he was okay, but he turned into a washout. And what happens? The St. Louis Rams, in one of the few good front office moves they ever made, they got rid of Sam Bradford because he didn't have it anymore. That's all I did. Ken Casa was a great champion for over a year because of me. I made him a champion. It got to a point that everybody in this area referred to that title as Travis's belt. I made him a champion. I made him a great athlete, but he just didn't have it anymore. So it was addition by subtraction. Just like the Rams traded Sam Bradford, we traded Ken Casa, and he's no more.
Well, fair enough. I don't know how Mr. Casa is going to respond to
being... I really don't care how he responds.
Well, there you go. That answers that question. Moving on, sir. We saw, despite your best intentions, Ron Powers walked away from the Bruiser Brody Memorial Battle Royal with the trophy. So, I got to ask you, how do you feel about this? I know you
how
have
do
been,
I feel about
you've
it?
Been the staunchest, I don't want to call him attacker, but
how do I feel about it? Let me tell you how I feel about it. That was supposed to be my big night. They were going to take the Bruiser Brody Trophy. We were going to win it, and they were going to rename it the Travis Cook Memorial Trophy. It was going to be the red letter night of my career. And you will notice, if you go back and watch the video of that match, that we eliminated Ron Powers in that match. Eliminated him, clean as a whistle.
Sir,
and that Bob Orton comes in there and sticks his nose in and puts him back in a match he had no reason being in.
You say we eliminated him, but sir, that it was you and your interference that eliminated Mr.
It's
Powers.
A battle royal. Are there any rules truly in a battle royal? Of course there aren't, other than 2 feet got to touch the floor. His two big feet touched the floor. He was out. We eliminated him. But, you know, I've been thinking a lot lately because this whole charade's been going on for about a year. You've been a party to it. Herb Simmons has been a party to it. Everybody around here has been a party to it about Ron Powers and Red River Jack. And supposedly, they're two separate people. One of them just happens to be the same size and weight and wrestles the same style, has a mask on, and showed up with Ron Powers, lost a loser leave town match. You've been telling people it's two different people. Herb Simmons has been telling people it's two different people. I got a real good idea. Why don't we just... Stand back there, Sparky. Why don't we just take some point and put the two of them in a tag match? Ron Powers, Red River Jack. It'll never happen because they're the same person. You can't sign it. But I sure would like to see that.
Well, you say we've all been a part of it. It's just that, Travis, you've been on this crusade for a long time now. We still have no smoking gun. There's a lot of assumptions. There's a lot of people drawing their own conclusions. But
I have been on a crusade. I am a crusader for the truth. Much like Richard Nixon, I am a crusader for the truth. I get to the bottom of things that are wrong in this world. I am one of the few moral, upstanding people you have left in this country. Wipe that off your chin. I am one of the few moral, righteous, upstanding people we have in this country who will get to the bottom of things and get to the truth. So rest assured, if we had a tag match with those two, I could get to the truth. I could get to the truth. Now, there's one other dude I want to talk about. There's a guy running around here named Ricky Cruz. Another guy. Ricky. Down until Ricky Cruz.
Is he okay?
He's hungry, but that's none of your business. Ricky Cruz, a young man, well, not really a young man, a veteran, who I saved his career just a few months ago. He had nothing. He'd lost his championship. He was on the way out, and I took him, I polished him up, and I gave him a career. And what thanks did I get? He turned on me. And rather than being here in the Midwest and taking his beating, he ran off to Mexico on some kind of whirlwind tour. He's got everybody thinking, oh, we did this great tour in Mexico. He's such a great international superstar. No, you aren't, buddy. You ran down to a third world country so we couldn't beat your head in. Well, anybody can go down to Mexico and beat up midgets for a couple of months. But it takes a man to come up here and deal with the international bounty hunter, Attila Khan. Ricky Cruz, you've got Attila Khan in just a few weeks. You might want to take another beeline from Mexico, buddy.
Well, you heard him. He's the crusader. We'll see how this crusade continues.
The crusader for truth and justice.
Will he find truth and justice? Be here June the 20th. Ricky Cruz takes on the international bounty hunter Attila Khan, and we have a challenge laid out. Travis Cook wants Ron Powers and Red River Jack in the same place at the same time. Will he get his wish?
That'll never happen.
June 20th. Stay tuned to Wrestling Explosion.
Farm Music and Fun, the place to party, is Pop's nightclub and concert venue in Sojay. From Bruno Mars or the first U.S. tour of Nickelback to Flogging Molly or the Insane Clown Posse, 30 years of memories pack Pop's concert venue with more made at every new show. And there's a party at Pop's nightclub every night, a melting pot of friends enjoy the best in dance, rock, pop, and top 40 music until 5:30 a.m. Plus, add a full game room. Check out all the action at PopsRocks.com. Then and now, the place to party is Pop's in Sojay.
Here we go, looking at two of the tough guys of SICW, the old school warrior, Chaz Wesson, taking on Waco.
Absolutely, and Waco, bit of sound strategy. Those chops aren't going to hurt as much with a shirt on, I'll say that much. But Waco taking the fight to Chaz Wesson here, driving that knee in the corner.
Going for that quick pinfall.
Waco trying to press his advantage here. And there's that chop echoing through the East Carondelet Community Center. Packed house, as you can see, and there's that trademark dropkick of Chaz Wesson.
Beautiful dropkick.
And gets a two count just like that. Chaz has turned this around just like that. Reversal. Power slam, snapped him over. And Chaz Wesson looking to go to the third floor here, perhaps looking to put this one away early. High rent district, as they say. Cross body,
very
shades
nice.
Of Ricky Steamboat. And that'll do it.
It doesn't take Chaz Wesson that long to pick up the victory over Waco.
Let Custom Truck Upholstery give your vehicle a facelift. Visit us on 707 North 20th Street in East St. Louis, Illinois. Custom Truck Upholstery merges old-world craftsmanship and attention to detail with the latest in modern technology to make your car, truck, boat, or motorcycle look like new. Call Custom Truck Upholstery at
618-875-9850. Here we go, and the action is underway against two of the men who are making their way up the ladder in SICW, your Canadian hero, Sean Vincent, taking on the man that calls himself Dead Sexy, Daniel Gunner.
And now a Fujiwara armbar by Daniel Gunner. As I said, perhaps underrated technically. We haven't seen everything, perhaps haven't seen everything Daniel Gunner has to offer.
Absolutely right.
We're seeing a little more of it here. Sean Vincent, very close to tapping out there, but Daniel Gunner looking to take out another page of the game plan here. Sean Vincent turning him around for the backslide. One, two, very close.
Not enough this time. Daniel Gunner back to that arm.
And nice maneuver there. Another modified armbar here by Daniel Gunner. Showing a lot of different maneuvers to damage that left arm of Sean Vincent.
Absolutely. And that's just plain old smart. I mean, if you have one wing, that pretty much disables a good percentage of the wrestling moves that you can do inside those ropes.
And even moves that don't necessarily involve the arm, it can affect your balance, your leverage, all sorts of things in that ring. And just the pain of an injured limb can mess with you mentally and throw you off your game.
Absolutely.
And Sean Vincent trying to get back to his feet, trying to regain that leverage.
Kind of feeding off of the energy from the crowd to get back to his feet, did your Canadian hero.
And Vincent going for the legs. We've seen him use that Maple Leaf leg lock a few times. But Gunner going back to that arm.
Back to that arm, he's like a pit bull.
And that's the mark of a smart wrestler. If he gets to work on a body part, he stays on it. He sticks with that game plan. Definitely impressed by Daniel Gunner here. We haven't seen him get a whole lot of marks in the win column, but he's showing that he's not to be underestimated here. But a dragon screw leg whip by Sean Vincent.
Absolutely. Smart move by Sean Vincent, starting to weaken up that leg. We've seen Sean Vincent's new finisher, the leg lock that he calls the Maple Leaf.
A move I hadn't seen him use until recently. I mean, for a little while, Vincent was using the more traditional figure four leg lock. But Vincent decided to try something a little bit different, something that not as many people would have seen. So he went with that different leg hold, and he's been winning with it.
Well, and that's just another thing that goes to show the veteranship, if that's a word, of these two guys, is even though both of these men have been doing this for a long, long time, neither one of them has stopped learning. They're still adding weapons to their arsenal, and they are still evolving. So a lot of times you'll see wrestlers start to rest on their laurels once they've been doing this for a long, long time. Not these two guys.
And Daniel Gunner went to the eyes a little bit ago to try to regain control. And he could sense that Sean Vincent had the momentum going in his favor. But Vincent takes him down by the legs again, trying to get that Maple Leaf. Gunner, though, sees it coming and gets to the ropes. These two seem to have each other well scouted. But Vincent going back to the leg lock. Small package by Gunner.
Yeah, not this time, says Gunner. Didn't get him.
This has been quite the competitive matchup here. Gunner rolls him up. One, two.
But going for those ropes. You know, Daniel Gunner picked up a victory several months ago by using the ropes for leverage, and Denny Thomas was the man that he got one over on. Denny Thomas, he learned from his mistake that one time, and Daniel Gunner has been trying that every time pretty much, and Denny's onto his tricks.
And Gunner risking disqualification there, putting his hands on the official. But Sean Vincent, he's got that Maple Leaf now.
That's why you can never take your eyes off your opponent. You can never get distracted by these referees or by these fans, because this is what can happen.
And Gunner made that crucial mistake, and it cost him. He's in the middle of the ring, and Gunner taps out.
That's it. This Canadian Maple Leaf, just too much for Daniel Gunner on this occasion. 7 minutes and 3 seconds. SICW fans, join us in the East Carondelet Community Center on June the 20th for a fantastic night of action. We try to get deeper into the Red River Jack mystery as Red River Jack teams with Ron Powers to take on the Travis Cook organization. Plus, old school warrior Chaz Wesson challenges for the Classic Wrestling Championship against our champ, Flash Flanagan. For tickets, call 618-286-4848 or visit us on SICW.org.
From the World Series champion Tigers in 45 to the Gateway Grizzlies to the 03 state tournament Belleville East Lancers, a tradition in baseball and an even longer tradition in fine furniture and service. Miller Furniture, 1004 East Main in Belleville.
Wow, folks. Look at that beautiful trophy. This was made specifically for this exact event. Ron Powers, he couldn't be happier. Look at the smile on his face. First of all, what he had to go through just to get into this battle royal. And then he thought he was eliminated just about 5 minutes ago before the director of operations did the right thing and inserted Ron Powers back into this match. Here we see the lovely Barbara Goodish, the widow of Bruiser Brody, presenting Ron Powers with this spectacular trophy.
Absolutely, Drew. I mean, it couldn't mean more to Ron Powers, a former protege of Bruiser Brody. As I said, a man who traveled the roads with him. It means so much to him to hold that trophy named in honor of his mentor, King Kong Bruiser Brody.
Absolutely right. Ron Powers has worked as hard as anybody, along with Herb Simmons, along with Larry Matisick, in keeping the memory of Bruiser Brody alive. So seeing him being able to take this trophy home with him, I know Ron Powers has a heck of a gym at his house with a lot of trophies that he keeps from his past in the powerlifting days and other things that he's accumulated from his wrestling career. I have to imagine this trophy is going to be in the premier spot in Mr. Powers' trophy case.
Absolutely. This night means a lot to Ron Powers, and it means a lot to the capacity crowd here at the East Carondelet Community Center, many of whom remember the heyday of King Kong Bruiser Brody. Saw him in those classic battles in St. Louis and all around the world. And so many people here paying tribute to King Kong Bruiser Brody.
You're absolutely right. You heard that roar as soon as it was announced that Ron Powers was the winner of this thing. People were really disappointed because a lot of our fans saw what Travis Cook did to eliminate Ron Powers. But like we said, the director of operations righted that wrong. And now you see Ron Powers, the very first recipient of the Bruiser Brody Memorial Trophy. What an episode of Wrestling Explosion this was, folks, and we've got another great episode lined up for you next week. We have a very special treat as the Mighty Midgets go one-on-one inside the SICW ring. Also, the Classic Wrestling Championship on the line as our very first and the only two-time Classic Champion, Flash Flanagan, defends versus the Man of Tomorrow, Daniel Eads. Next week.
This ring with Red River Jack, and then Travis Cook has nothing to complain about. June 20th.
I don't know what to say to that, Herb. I guess I'll have to let the director of operations answer that one.
All right, we're going to make that happen. Ron Powers and Red River Jack, June 20th. Right here, we're tagging against whoever Travis Cook.